Please subscribe our channel, Knowledge Distributor, for latest technology and smartphone videos.
Or the iPhone XR. Now, this video was inspired because a lot of people are saying that the Samsung Galaxy Note 9 is actually cheaper than the iPhone XR in their country, as well as, you know, any other iPhone. And the Galaxy Note 9 here in the US is also cheaper than the iPhone XR if you trade in an old smartphone or you get it on a carrier. A lot of deals are going on right now, and especially if you find this on like a place like eBay, for example. The Galaxy Note 9, I've seen it for like $750. That's the same price as the iPhone XR with 64 gigabytes, and you can't get the Note 9 with less than 128 gigabyte, and they both have expandable memory. So the Galaxy Note 9 is definitely right off the bat a better value when it comes to storage. Galaxy Note 9 and the iPhone XR are actually pretty similar here. They both have glass backs. They both have aluminum sides on the edges of the Note 9. You could see them right there. They're both a pretty premium feeling phone, although I think that the Note 9, because it's a bigger phone, the weight is better distributed, so it kind of feels not too heavy for its size, whereas this iPhone XR is less weight than the Note 9, but because it's in a shorter body, that weight is just, you can feel it more. It just feels like a little thick, chunky little phone, but definitely feels premium, so it's something to hold on to. You can feel that weight a little bit more in the iPhone XR. Now, some people might associate that with feeling more premium. So if you feel like a weightier phone feels more premium, you will like the build of the iPhone XR. The feel in the hand, this corner of the Galaxy Note 9 definitely stabs your palm a little bit more than the smooth edge on the iPhone XR. So I think the iPhone XR feels more comfortable in the palm, but you're trading off a lot of display for that slightly more comfortable feeling here on the Galaxy Note 9. You can see just how much bigger that display does look. So in terms of display, the Galaxy Note 9 is a stunner display, the best one I've seen on any smartphone this year. And you can see that it does do a landscape mode. You can go into settings here for the Note 9, and you could go down to display. And you could see you could change this to any resolution you want. You want to take it down to the XR, go to HD plus right there. The XR is a little higher res than that. So maybe the XR is probably like in between HD plus and full HD. If there was an option like right in there, that's the XR's display. But you can see this one goes all the way up there to WQHD plus. So beautiful resolution here. The Note 9 will never disappoint you when it comes to the display. You're gonna have this phone a year later and you're still gonna be in awe at how good the display is. I mean, the Galaxy Note 8 still looks beautiful to this day, beautiful and more beautiful than many other phones that had just got released. So the Note series is killing it when it comes to display. The iPhone XR is a stunner in display when it comes to the design for an LCD. The iPhone XR's display is pretty premium for an LCD panel coming all the way down to the edge. That's a pretty nice engineering feat from Apple. However, the resolution is not the highest. You can see a little pixelation when you do get close to the panel, but overall it's not bad at all. And I think if anybody's buying this phone, take a look at it in the store. I don't think most people are upset with it. Some people are even saying they like it better than the 8 plus, they like it better than the 7 plus, and those phones had 1080p. So this phone has been pretty shocking in that it's not as bad as everybody's making it out to be. However, these phones right here side by side, it's a crushing win for the Note 9, and anybody who's turned off the light and seen these in the dark would easily see that the Note 9 is superior to that of the iPhone XR. So in terms of software, the Galaxy Note 9 runs 8.1.0 Oreo, still not on the latest Android 9 Pie. I'm not actually upset about that because I don't really like the way Android 9 Pie's gestures are working right now. I hope they get it really smooth, because on the Pixel sometimes it just doesn't work that fast, like this old card UI. But on the Galaxy Note 9, it's got that Samsung experience above it, and that gives you all that multitasking ability. We know what it's all about. You got the Edge over here, just a ton of features you can do. Use your S Pen, you have all of this productivity enhancement right here. Going over, you can put widgets on your screen, you can change your themes on this phone. I mean, this phone is totally customizable, and this is like the best theme store I've seen on any phone. So this phone right here is super customizable, features everywhere. Everything you might be saying, why doesn't my XR do that? This phone does. So this is a no compromise software package when it comes to features. However, you're compromising on software updates because it rarely receives software updates. It takes forever to get an update on the Galaxy Note 9. So be happy with what the Galaxy Note 9 offers you. It runs smooth, but don't expect software updates every day. You will get security patches monthly though, but you're not going to see like major upgrades. Now, the iPhone XR is running the latest iOS 12.1, which brings group FaceTime, all new emojis to the device. And iOS 12, since the start, has been a pretty solid software in terms of performance. Many features like screen time, Siri shortcuts, and more. There's just so much going on with iOS 12, but it's not a total redesign when it comes to the look and feel. So if you're used to iOS of before, you'll feel right at home with the XR, unless you haven't used a gesture base. You're just gonna have to get used to this little swipe mechanism to operate the phone. Pulling down from the top brings you to your control center. Again, it used to be at the bottom if you're an older iPhone user. It's at the top now. So no multitasking split screen on this phone. You can do, you know, one app at a time, but there's going to be no splitting here for the Apple iPhone XR. So it's a pretty single, simple kind of experience of applications for the XR, which some people might actually desire. Now, discussing the performance day to day, the Galaxy Note 9 is a very fast smartphone with 8 gigabytes of RAM. This is the 500 gigabyte model I have right here. This phone flies through everything. And actually, of all the phones I've used this year with 8 gigabytes of RAM, Snapdragon 845, the Note 9, while it's not the smoothest, buttery smooth looking phone I've ever used, it's like one of the fastest phones I've ever used. This phone can handle like 20 apps at the same time, 20 tabs in your internet browser. This thing never chokes up in terms of performance. So if you're looking for great performance on an Android phone, the Note 9 with that 8 gigabytes of RAM has it. So check out that one if you really want the top dog performance for a smartphone. The Note 9 is a beast where it matters, and that is in applications, multitasking, and regardless of the fact that on paper, the iPhone XR's A12 Bionic is blowing away, leaving the Note 9 in the dust. In the real world use, you don't even see that. So that's not a major factor. Unless you're trying to keep this phone for like 5 years, I think the Note 9 is still gonna last a good 3. So either one you go with, performance, you're gonna be very happy with on both. Discussing their audio differences, you do get the Dolby Atmos feature for the Galaxy Note 9, and it has a pretty loud speaker. The iPhone XR also has a pretty loud speaker. I find the XR's speakers to sound a little bit more clear when you are listening to something on the phone. However, I find the Note 9s to feel just about as loud as the XR. So when you're watching a video or you're playing some kind of music track, they both have pretty good audio. But the Galaxy Note 9, again, with that headphone jack, is a nice touch. Discussing biometrics, you do have a fingerprint scanner here, and you will have iris scanning on the front of here, as well as a face unlock. Now with the XR, I have Face ID. I'm not gonna lock it right now. You could see it right there, infrared sensor. You could see you in the dark, and it's better in the dark than the Galaxy Note 9. It's actually more accurate than the face unlock on the Note 9. However, the Note 9 does have many options. So if you like options on how to unlock, you're gonna love the Galaxy Note 9. But the XR's Face ID is super awesome when it can authenticate in applications like banks and other things. I think you'll really like that about the XR. So Face ID on a cheaper iPhone is kind of cool because you had to pay $1,000 to get that last year. In terms of phone call and reception, the Galaxy Note 9 and the XR have actually given me equal performance. They both never dropped the call, and they both are sounding pretty good on the earpiece, had no issues with calling. So I think it's a wash here on phone call quality. They're both pretty good there. Talking about their battery life, about equal actually. I've been seeing about the same battery life on both of these. I will consider doing a full battery drain test on the XR coming soon. You've seen it for the Galaxy Note 9 already on the channel. So don't make your decision just based on battery life. It's not that much different. So in terms of their cameras, the Galaxy Note 9 has a dual camera with an optical lens on there, and you do have a better aperture for low light photos. And that's basically what I've seen with the Note 9, is it can do better low light photography. It also has pro modes, live focus, panorama. It has a lot more, I would say, in-depth features, and it's all right here in the camera app for the Galaxy Note 9. But on the iPhone XR, you do have your classic iPhone camera. Super simple, anybody can use this video, slow-mo time-lapse. It does get a little tricky if you wanna change some settings. You gotta go into camera settings all the way buried in the settings application. If you can ever find it, you go down, you find camera, and here is everything you can do for 4K 60, 24, 60fps. No recording limit. Where you do get a recording limit on the Galaxy Note 9, you have smart HDR here, but you also have a kind of AI kind of smart feature for HDR for the Note 9 as well. So they both can detect things and try to change the exposures and stuff like that. Both of them shoot fantastic photos. So that's it. In conclusion, which one is better, the Galaxy Note 9 or the iPhone XR? Which one are you going to go with? I think that they're actually quite comparable besides the screens on both of these devices. They're both premium feeling smartphones. They both have aluminum sides. This one has IP68. This one has IP67. Didn't mention that. Both have good phone call quality. Both have stellar cameras. Both have stellar battery life. Just if you want a bigger, better screen, you got to get the Note 9. And I think for the price point being around the same price, the Note 9 just offers more. So for me, the Galaxy Note 9 is the better deal here between these two. But if you wanted to pay Note 9 prices for an iPhone, the XR is still a nice deal for at least Apple devices. So which one would you choose here? Note 9, iPhone XR? Let me know your thoughts down below. If you guys found this video helpful, entertaining, informing, enjoying, do me a favor.